This provides reliable delivery. That's it means that acknowledgements are sent for the segments which are received successfully without any error. Okay. And if any segment is lost, so then retransmission is done. Okay. So retransmission is done in two cases. One is when the timer expires, or when the receiver sends three duplicate acknowledgements, okay, back to back. Okay, so this we call it as a fast retransmission, this process, because I told you that flow control technique it uses, that is a combination of go back and selective repeat. Okay, so in go back, like go back and, it doesn't send any negative acknowledgement. And like selective repeat, it accepts the segments which are coming out of sequence also. Okay, so it stores them. So the sender is not required to send or retransmit all the frames, all the segments which were lost. Okay, so that's why if some segment is missing and that receiver wants that that segment should be delivered, because it delivers the data in a sequence. So it sent three back-to-back duplicate acknowledgments. So that is, we call it as a fast retransmission. So the sender will retransmit that data. Okay, and no retransmission timer is set for acknowledgement segment. Data may be arrive at out of order and temporarily stored at the receiving TCP, but TCP will guarantee that no out of order segment is delivered to the process. So it will arrange that data and deliver in a sequence. Okay. So here we can see, this is a normal operation. It is both way communication. So this client is sending, this is a sequence number. So, and the data bytes are from 1201 to 1400 and acknowledgement is 4001. Okay. And the sender server send the data from 4001 to 5000 bytes. And this is the acknowledgement of this one. So it means it has received the byte number 1400. Now it is expecting byte number 1401. And this way they keep on communicating. So in this case, no segment is lost, no acknowledgement is lost. Okay. And it is a normal operation. Now, what happens if some segment is lost? Okay. So here, first segment sent, second segment sent, acknowledgement sent. So third segment was lost, then fourth segment sent. Then here, this receiver will receive the segment which is coming out of order, and it will keep a gap for the segment which is not received, okay, in the sequence, which is lost. Then the sender don't have to retransmit all the segments after that. Only the segment which is lost, that has to be retransmitted, okay? So the gap is kept for the segment which is lost. The next segment which is coming out of order is stored in the buffer. And again, the next segment is received. So it will send the acknowledgement again that it is expecting frame number, segment number 701. So when the receiver will receive this, it means that this segment was lost somewhere. So it will retransmit that. So here timer expired, and after that it transmitted the segment. Okay. And now that segment was stored here in the gap where it was kept. And now it is in the data which is received in the proper sequence, and it is delivered to the process. Okay. This is when the segment is lost. Okay. This is fast retransmission. How that three back-to-back acknowledgements are sent. So in this case, you see the one segment transmitted, second segment transmitted. Excuse me. And acknowledgement. After that, this segment lost, then next segment was transmitted, next segment. See, these three segments were transmitted, this segment was lost, okay? So here, the gap was kept for this segment, which was lost, 301 segment, okay? And remaining all other were received, but it cannot deliver this data to the process, to the higher layer, because this is out of sequence. So it will, this segment is lost, so for this, it will send this acknowledgement back to back three times. So ACK301, ACK301, ACK301. So this is known as fast retransmission. Okay. It is known as fast retransmission. So even if the timer is not expired at the sender side. After receiving these three back-to-back acknowledgement, sender will retransmit that segment. So it is retransmitted. So that segment is stored here, and then now that all the data is in the order and delivered to the higher layer. Okay. So this is the process of fast retransmission. So retransmissions occur in two cases. One is when your timer expires. Second is when you receive three back-to-back acknowledgement from the receiver, three same duplicate back-to-back acknowledgement from the receiver. So in that case, the fast retransmission occurs. So these are the two cases when the sender will retransmit any segment. So in this, this was a connection-oriented service. Okay, in connection-oriented service, there is a virtual connection established between sender and receiver, and all the data is being transmitted. This is connectionless service. Okay, connectionless service, packet zero received here, packet two received before, packet one, and like that. Okay, and message two is delivered out of order. Okay, UDP will not take care of that. Connectionless service will not take care of that proper sequencing and all that, but TCP will take care of that. Okay, then this is connection oriented service. Connection first, this three-way handshaking, connection open request, reply, again acknowledgement, and then the data transmission. Okay, so this is connection establishment phase. Which flag we use for this, which flags we use for connection establishment, three-way handshaking? Anyone remembers? Which flag is set for connection establishment? Yes, anyone?
SYN.
Yes, SYN. Okay, that the client send, then receiver replies with which flag? Not only ACK.
SYN plus ACK.
SYN plus ACK, both. Yes, and then sender replies with the
ACK.
ACK. Then that connection establishment is completed. Okay. And for connection closing, for connection termination, which flag is set? Yes, FIN.
FIN flag.
Yes, FIN flag. And receiver replies with? Receiver replies with?
FIN plus ACK.
FIN plus ACK if it also wants to close the connection. Okay. In half close connection, it will provide only ACK. Otherwise, FIN plus ACK. And then sender will reply with the ACK. So then the connection will be closed. Okay, so this is first connection establishment, then data transmission, acknowledgements are received. Even if these packets are received out of sequence, they are arranged at the side, and then connection termination, connection closing. Okay, so this is how the data transmission takes place in a TCP or connection oriented service. Okay, so these were two protocols of transport layer, TCP and UDP. Okay, one more protocol is there, which is, this is not in our syllabus, but you should know at least for your interviews and for that. Okay, this is not in our syllabus at this time. Okay. That is SCTP, Stream Control Transmission Protocol. Okay, Stream Control Transmission Protocol. So it is new, reliable, message-oriented transport layer protocol, and it is designed for internet applications, which we recently what we are using, and it is even better than that TCP, and you can say it provides best feature of UDP and TCP. So you can say basically it is a combination of best features of UDP and TCP, but it is reliable, message oriented, like TCP is byte oriented, na? So it is message oriented, but this is not in our syllabus, so I'm not going to teach you. If you want, you can go through this. Okay, so this was about your this UDP and TCP. Okay, now next is our congestion control and quality of service. This is also the function of transport layer. Okay, so transport layer provides or helps in congestion controlling, and it provides quality of service. Okay, so the main focus of the congestion control and quality of service is data traffic. So when the data traffic, what we are trying to send, so the main policy should be we should avoid traffic congestion, because if there is a traffic in the network, if there is a congestion, our packets, our data will be transmitted with a delay, and our data may be lost also. Okay, so if the router is congested, its buffer is full, so then it will drop our packets. Okay, so that's why we are going to discuss this congestion control and quality of service. But before that, we should know what is the data traffic itself. Okay, so this we can say this is a data traffic. Data traffic is not like that. This key, there is no fixed the data generation rate. Sometimes when the sender has a data, it can generate 20 bytes per second, 1000 bytes per second, or when it is not having any data to transmit, it will not generate any data at all. Okay, so at that time it will be idle. So that's why you can say this data generation rate and data transmission rate varies. It is not fixed. So sometimes at the peak time it will be highest, at the minimum time it will be minimum, and this is way how we can find out that average data rate, when the average of when the data rate was highest and when the data transmission rate was lowest. So these are three types of traffic profiles. First is constant bit rate. So in this, data rate is generated at the constant speed, like 1000 bits per second, 100 bits per second, like that, constantly. They are generating at the same speed. Then variable bit rate, in that sometimes 10 bits per second, sometimes 80 bits per second, sometimes 100 bits per second, sometimes 60 bits per second, like that, that variable. Then bursty, in the bursty, sometimes you have 1000 bits per second, then no data, 0 bits per second, then again 500 bits per second, like that. Okay, so these are three types of traffic. Okay, so congestion, what we call it is a congestion. Congestion in the network, when the load of the network, see, when the number of packets which are sent in the network is greater than the capacity of the network. So the number of packet of a network can handle. So congestion control refers to the mechanism and techniques to control the congestion and keep the load below the capacity. This is like our road traffic. So when the number of vehicles are more than the on the road, then the number of vehicles can flow smoothly, then there is a traffic in the road. So when there is a traffic in the road, everything is affected. The traffic move very slow, it consume a lot of time. So similarly, when there are more data in the network than that, than its capacity, so then that time there will be congestion in the network. And there are queues or the router, input and output. So when there is a congestion, so if it is receiving more data, then it can process. So it will store that data into the these buffers, these queues. Once these queues are full, that time what will happen, it will start dropping those incoming packets, extra incoming packets. Okay, because it cannot store them, it cannot process them. And when the, those packets or those data are dropped here, then ICMP will send a error message. Okay, so that is also again generating traffic. And when the then the receiver will retransmit the data. Okay. So this is like packet delay. If there is no congestion in the network, then the delay will be very less. Otherwise, if there is a congestion, yeah, there will be delay, more delay, then throughput will be very less. Okay, so like that, all these things are there. So congestion control techniques. Okay, so we know that there can be congestion in the network, so we have to follow certain congestion control techniques. So what are these congestion control techniques and how these are used and how these help to control the congestion? That's very important. So there are basically, we can say, we can divide these things into two categories. So one is open loop congestion control, another is closed loop congestion control. Okay, open loop congestion control and closed loop congestion control. Okay, so in open loop, these are different types or techniques to control the congestion under this open loop category, and these are different techniques to control the congestion under this closed loop category. Okay, so first is retransmission policy. Okay, so retransmission policy, you know that retransmission is unavoidable. If your data packet was lost or it was corrupted, then sender has to retransmit the data. But when we retransmit the data, that increase the congestion in the network. Definitely we are adding more traffic into the network. So the retransmission policy should be designed in such a way that it prevents the congestion. It will not add congestion. Okay, so this retransmission policy and retransmission timer, so they should be designed to optimize efficiency and prevent congestion. Because if you set our retransmission timer to a very long time, then definitely it is going to affect the efficiency. Okay, because if the packet was lost and then your timer is not expiring and the sender is receiver is waiting for your packet, okay, then that is not efficient way. But if your timer expires very early, very fast, then it will add, might be that your packet was on the way, it received, reached, and acknowledgement is also on the way, but you retransmit that, transmitted the packet. Okay, so the retransmission policy and the retransmission timer should be designed in such a way that that is a we can say balance between the efficiency and the congestion control. Okay, then window policy. We know that sender has a window and it can transmit the bytes in that window without waiting for the acknowledgement. Okay, so if we select go back n and selective repeat, if we have to choose, so definitely selective repeat is better than go back n, because in the go back n, if one segment is lost, the sender has to retransmit all the segments starting from that particular thing. But in selective repeat, only the segment which was lost should be retransmitted. This on just now we saw in that previous slides how that TCP takes care of that. Okay, it will just keep that segment which is not received, the gap it will maintain for that segment, and remaining it will accept and store, it will not discard them. Okay, so the policy and the window side again should be designed in such a way that that it will not add extra traffic to the congestion. Okay, then acknowledgement policy. Then acknowledgement also, we know that when we send something, the receiver replies with the acknowledgement. Okay, so the acknowledgement policy should be like that. No need to send the acknowledgement, you can send cumulative acknowledgement. Rather than sending acknowledgement for every segment, you can send cumulative acknowledgement also. But sometimes what happens, we wait for, like, I'll send acknowledgement for four segments, so till the time you wait, the sender's timer will expire, he will retransmit, then there is no use. So that again acknowledgement policy is should be such a way that it will not add any extra traffic into the network. Okay, then discarding policy. Sometimes the router, to avoid the congestion, they will discard the packet. Okay, so when we are transmitting audio, so that time the router will discard less sensitive packets when there is a congestion. Okay, but it will take care the quality of the sound is still preserved, that quality and integrity of the sound will not be disturbed, it will take care of that. Okay, but it will discard those less sensitive packets. So discarding policy again should be in such a way that if whatever the packet it is discarding, it that should not affect the quality of the data which is going to be retransmission. Then admission policy. Admission policy is like when this connection establishment is done, three-way handshaking. Okay. If there is already congestion in the network or there is a congestion in the router, so whenever any sender is trying to establish a virtual circuit connection, so that time they can deny that admission, they can deny for that virtual circuit connection. So that if there is already congestion in the network, okay, if it is a normal condition, then it can accept. Excuse me. So all these are the techniques under the open loop category to avoid the congestion. Then closed loop. In closed loop, first is back pressure. Back pressure is like if in this node there is a congestion, this node is facing congestion. So it will inform its previous node that slow down, I have a congestion. Okay, I cannot handle more than this data. So then this node will give indication to its previous node, like slow down. This node will give indication to the previous node. And this way this indication will reach to the source. So to slow down, don't transmit at this speed. Okay, so like that this back pressure method works. So the node which is facing the congestion, it will indicate, it will tell the previous node to slow down, then to previous node to slow down, to reach to source to slow down, not to transmit much data. Sorry, I'm not well actually. Then a choke packet. This is the next technique. In choke packet, rather than telling to the previous node directly, the node transmit or send a special packet which is known as a choke packet to the source only. Because if you continuously sending the back pressure, so slowly it will take time to reach to the source, that there is a network congestion. The source will not slow down so easily. Okay, so the congestion, the node which is having the congestion will directly send a choke packet to source to slow down, not to transmit the data at the faster speed. Okay, so that is the choke packet technique. Now there were two more techniques there. Here, implicit signaling and explicit signaling. Implicit signaling and explicit signaling, these I'll explain when these are used in that frame relay technique. Okay. Okay. So now we'll discuss two techniques, how the congestion is controlled in TCP and how congestion control in frame relay. So whatever techniques we discuss now, these techniques are used in this. Okay. So this congestion control in TCP is very important. The congestion control in TCP is very, very important. Okay. The congestion control in frame relay is easy because it sends the signal to the previous node like that to slow down. But this congestion control in TCP is very important. Okay, so we are going to discuss this congestion control in TCP. Excuse me. So I hope this not just give me a break. I'll have water and come. Thank you. So we'll discuss congestion control in TCP. So this is visible. My sheet is properly visible, and whatever I'm writing is visible. Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
But
it's blur.
It is a blur.
Ma'am, can you use another color of ink?
Okay, another color of pen. Okay, I'll try. Now okay, better hai?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so in this one is congestion window. ये पेन से बेटर है, प्रॉपर दिख रहा है?
यस मैम।
ओके, सो कंजेशन विंडो, ओके, सो वी नो दैट हाउ विंडो साइज इज फिक्स्ड हियर, सो विंडो साइज इज फिक्स्ड हियर, विंडो साइज इन टीसीपी इज सेट मिनिमम ऑफ, देयर आर टू वेरिएबल्स ना, रिसीवर window size and congestion window size. Okay, so whatever is the minimum from this is fixed. Then second is congestion policy. Second is congestion policy. Okay, so this congestion policy has the window, there will be window size will be one. You transmit one segment. If you receive acknowledgement, increase the window size, just exponentially increase. So next time window size will be two. You transmit two segment without waiting for acknowledgement. If you receive acknowledgement for both, next time window size will be four. Okay, so you transmit four segments without waiting for the acknowledgement. If you receive acknowledgement for four segment, next time you increase the window size to 8, then 16, 32, 64, 128, like that. Till the time your timer expire or there is a threshold, because in this way, if you continue to increase, you will reach to infinity. Okay, so there is a threshold value set. So this exponential growth will continue till the time either your threshold is reached or your timer expired or you received three back-to-back acknowledgement. It means your packet was lost. Okay, so only the name is slow start, but it is basically not slow start, it is exponential growth only. So you send one segment, two segment, four segment, eight segment, 16 segment, till the time either you reaches to threshold or or your packet or segment was lost. Okay, so that is slow start. That is first phase. I'll explain this with example, don't worry if you are not understanding also. Okay, then second phase is in this congestion avoidance, and here additive increase. So this phase is additive increase. So suppose you reach threshold here, you transmitted one segment, two, your window size was 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 is your supposed threshold. After 16, the threshold, what you will do, you start increasing window size by 1. So 16 if your threshold, then 17 window size, next time 18, then 19, 20, 21, 22, like that. Again, you have to continue this till your segment is lost. So how your segment will lost, you will come to know, either your timer expired, you didn't receive acknowledgement, your timer got expired, or you received 3 back-to-back acknowledgement. Okay, you got 3 back-to-back acknowledgement. Now if your timer expired or you received 3 back-to-back acknowledgement, it means there is traffic in the network, there is congestion. So now you have to congestion detection. So that is next third phase, congestion detection. So suppose you detected the congestion, so what you have to do, you have to multiplicative decrease. Then what you will do, you will set the threshold half, and either you will start from the slow start or you will start from the additive increase. That depends how you detected the congestion. If you detected the congestion by timer, okay, so by timeout, your timer expired, so by timeout if you detected the congestion, then what you will do, you set threshold to half and begin with slow start. It means again you set the window size to 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 till your threshold. If you detected the congestion by 3 back-to-back duplicate acknowledgement, if you received 3 back-to-back duplicate acknowledgements, and then what you have to do, same, set threshold to half of that window size, whatever was the half window size, and what you do, you start with this additive increase and start with additive increase. Okay, so only just this concept of what we are doing should be clear to you. You will understand in better way when we will discuss an example. I'll solve one example for this. Okay, so just basically, if this thing is clear, overall idea is clear. Okay, yes, if any doubt in this, I should repeat something from this. Should I repeat? Is this clear? Okay, now I'll show one example. I hope that time will end this. Okay, so now ऐसे पेज विजिबल है ना, यहाँ पे ऐसे ड्रॉ करूं तो properly. So here, देखो, suppose this, we are going to draw this graph this way. Okay. Now suppose this is our congestion window size. So this is our congestion window size. Okay. So congestion window size is, so suppose we are marking 0, 2, 4, like this, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 20, 18, 20, 22, 24, like this, okay? And rounds, the first round, second round, so first round, second round, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, so round 0, round 1, round 2, round 3, round 4, 5, 6, like this, okay? So initially, the first phase is your slow start. Slow start. So suppose our threshold is 16. Okay. So suppose our threshold is 16. It is set. Okay. So what we have to do in first round, one frame will be, window size will be 1. In the first round, window size will be 1. In zeroth round, okay. In the first round, your window size will be 2. In the next round, your window size is going to be 4. Okay. In the next round, your window size is going to be 8. Okay. In the next round, your window size is going to be 16. Okay. So, in the first starting 0th round, your window size was 1. Next round, window size was 2. In the next round, window size was 4, 8, 16. Okay, now our threshold is 16. So this phase, we call it as a slow start phase. So this phase, what we have gone, this phase, we can call it as a slow start phase. So this is slow start phase. Yes, slow start phase, samajh mein aaya? Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then once we reach to the threshold, then your second phase start, that is additive increase. It means after this window size, after this, you don't go for the exponential growth. You increase window size 1 by 1, 17, 18, like that. So in the next round, go for 17. Excuse me. Okay. Then next round, go for 18. Then next round, go for 19. Okay. Next round, go for 20 window size. So after this threshold, go for additive increase. So in the next round, 16 was our threshold. So window size will be 17, then 18, then 19, then 20. This thing is known as additive increase. Okay, this thing will continue, this additive increase will continue till the time there is timeout or you receive 3 acknowledgement. Okay, if there is a timeout or you receive 3 acknowledgement, so we will consider both cases. So suppose when our window size was 20, here your timer expired. You didn't receive acknowledgement. So your timeout. Your timeout at window size 20. So what will happen? What will happen if... So here this phase was additive increase. This phase was additive increase. Now if you notice the congestion, this is a congestion detection phase. If you notice the condition when window size was 20 and the timeout happened, so now your threshold will be set to half of the current window size. Your threshold will be set to half of your current window size. So window size was 20. So now your threshold is 10. So this threshold is set to 10. Okay. And you start with the slow start. Again, go for the slow start. So in slow start, you set one frame. After this, you set sent window size will be 1, 2, 4, 8. After this 8, you cannot increase this by 16 because your threshold is 10. So after 8, you increase to 10. Okay. So 1, 2, 4, 8, and threshold is 10. So we cannot go 16. So 8, 10. Now your window size is 10. You reach to threshold. Again, you start. Which phase will start after reaching the threshold? So this is again slow start. Which phase will start after reaching to the threshold?
Additive phase.
Additive increase. So next time, 11, 12, okay, 10, 10, 11, 12. Now again, suppose at this stage, when window size was 12, we received 3 acknowledgements. It means again, we detected a congestion. When your window size was 12, we received 3 back-to-back acknowledgement. It means some of your packet or segment was lost. That's why we received the 3 back-to-back acknowledgement. Okay, so what will happen? So this was additive increase phase. So if we detected the congestion by 3 acknowledgements, what happened? You set the window size to half of this. So if 12 was the window size, set the threshold to 6. So now this threshold 6. So this threshold is set to 6. You come back to the threshold. Okay. And don't go with a slow start. From here, you start additive increase. Okay. Additive increase. So your window size became 6 and you go for 7, 8. Like this, additive increase. Okay. So this process of setting the window size half, we call it as a multiplicative decrease. Okay. So this also, when we set the window size again to 0, also 1, so that is multiplicative decrease. Okay. And then you start with the additive increase. Okay. So this is additive increase. Samajh mein aaya? Kuch doubt hai isme? Puchna hai? Repeat karna hai kuch mujhe? Is this clear to everyone? Anyone has any doubt? Should I repeat something from this?
Oh, ma'am, 3 acknowledgement kyun hua? Like, uska meaning kya hua?
3 acknowledgement, abhi maine aapko bola tha na, beta, retransmission do bar hoga. Do case mein hoga. Ek to apna packet apne bheja tha, uska acknowledgement nahi aaya, apna timer expire ho gaya. Okay? Dusra kya, wo ek segment lost hua tha. If you remember, starting mein maine jo aapko dikhaya tha screen, आपका एक सेगमेंट लॉस्ट हुआ, उसके बाद वाले सेगमेंट रिसीव हो गए उसको, तो सेंडर रिसीवर के पास वो सेगमेंट के लिए गैप है, बाकी डेटा उसको मिला है, तो वो क्या करेगा, फास्ट रिट्रांसमिशन के लिए 3 एक्नॉलेजमेंट, डुप्लीकेट एक्नॉलेजमेंट भेजेगा बैक टू बैक कि ये सेगमेंट तुम्हारा मिसिंग है. तो इवन इफ टाइमर एक्सपायर नहीं भी हुआ है तो भी सेंडर वो सेगमेंट रिट्रांसमिट कर देगा. ओके, सो इट मीन, हाँ बेटा,
यस यस,
हाँ, ओके, सो दैट्स वाई कि अगर हमें किसी सेगमेंट के लिए 3 एक्नॉलेजमेंट डुप्लीकेट मिला है, इट मींस वो सेगमेंट लॉस्ट हुआ है अपना. और सेगमेंट लॉस्ट क्यों हुआ है? बिकॉज कंजेशन है नेटवर्क में. ओके,
हाँ, अगर 3 एक्नॉलेजमेंट की जगह दूसरा वाला केस हुआ है, फिर टाइमर एक्सपायर हो गया, तब भी हमारा एडिटिव फेज से
नहीं, अगर टाइमर एक्सपायर हुआ तो थ्रेशोल्ड हाफ पे सेट होगा, बट स्लो स्टार्ट से स्टार्ट करेंगे, विंडो साइज 1 पे आ जाएगा. ओके, अगर 3 एक्नॉलेजमेंट हुआ तो थ्रेशोल्ड हाफ होगा और वो ही विंडो साइज होगा अपना. तो अगर 12 पे सपोज ये अपना वैल्यू 12 है, तो 12 पे अगर अपना हुआ 3 एक्नॉलेजमेंट, तो विंडो अपना थ्रेशोल्ड 6 हो गया और विंडो साइज भी 6 हो गया. तो 6, 7, 8 लाइक दैट. स्लो स्टार्ट पे नहीं जाएंगे, वापिस 1 से स्टार्ट नहीं करेंगे. ओके, बट अगर टाइम आउट हुआ है तो थ्रेशोल्ड हाफ होगा, बट विंडो साइज 1 हो जाएगा, 1, 2, 4, 8 लाइक दैट, वैसे जाएगा, स्लो स्टार्ट स्टार्ट हो जाएगा फेज. यस, कुछ और डाउट है किसी को? कुछ पूछना है, कुछ रिपीट करना है? ओके समझ में आया, क्लियर है. ओके यस, किसी को कुछ कुछ और डाउट है पूछना है? क्लियर, ओके. सो इफ इट इज क्लियर देन गुड. ये अपनी कंजेशन पॉलिसी है. स्लो स्टार्ट, एक्सपोनेंशियल ग्रोथ, कंजेशन विंडो साइज 1 पे रेसेट रहेगा. इट विल कंटिन्यू टू ग्रो एक्सपोनेंशियली टिल थ्रेशोल्ड 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 लाइक दैट टिल थ्रेशोल्ड. After reaching the threshold, congestion avoidance phase will start additive increase. So after threshold, it will start to increase one by one, 16, 17, 18, like that. It will continue to grow till the time congestion is detected. So congestion can be detected by two ways, by timeout and by three duplicate acknowledgements. And if it is detected by timeout, then your threshold will be set to half of that current window size, not of the previous threshold. Of the current window size, and slow start phase will begin. Or if this congestion is detected by three duplicate acknowledgement, then again the threshold will be set to half of that current window size, and window size also set to half of like equal to the threshold, and additive increase phase will start. Okay, additive increase phase will start. If anyone is having any doubt in this, you can ask because this is important. Now, if I give you a problem, can you draw this type of chart and define the phase, which phase, in which phase your system is going to work? Yes, if I give you a problem, can you? Okay. So if you have any doubt, you can ask right now because problem will be given to you on these things. It is clear then. Okay. Now this is the slow start by diagrammatic view. Okay, so here you can say the congestion window size is always 2 raised to the power. Okay, so here we can see so congestion window size is set to 1, 2 raised to power 0, one segment is transmitted. You received acknowledgement successfully. Window size is 2. Two segments transmitted. You received acknowledgement. Window size is 4. You can send 4 segments without waiting for acknowledgement. You receive acknowledgement. Window size is 8. So this is exponential increase. Slow start, exponential increase. Then transition avoidance. Window sizes is increased one by one. But this happens after reaching a threshold, okay? That is additive increase. Then congestion detection. So it can be detected by timeout, then new slow start phase will start. And if it is detected by 3 acknowledgement, then new congestion avoidance phase will start, okay? So this is the policy summary. We can say whatever we discuss, this is the policy summary, okay? Slow start, receive 3 acknowledgement, and then timeout. So depending on that, how the window size will be set and which phase will start. Okay. This is that example which we discuss right now. Now, another is, this was the congestion policy or congestion avoidance technique in TCP. Another type is frame relay. Okay, so another example is frame relay. Frame relay is a type of, again, a different type of network. So there, this backward explicit congestion notification. Okay, so in that, a special signal, a special packet is transmitted to the sender if there is a congestion in the network. Okay, in the frame relay, if there is a congestion, suppose in this direction there is a congestion in this network, what it will do, it will set a special frame which is known as backward explicit segment, so that it will transmit back to the sender that there is a congestion in the network. You slow down your rate of transmission. Then another is forward explicit congestion notification. So in this case, you have to inform to the receiver also, because if receiver is waiting for some segment and it is not receiving, so that time you have to inform the receiver also that there is a congestion in the network, your data is on the way but it is taking time. So that we call it as a forward explicit congestion notification. Okay, so in this, what happens, the packet which are going on that way, there only these bits are set, FECL or BECL. If you have to inform to backward side or forward side, so you have to set that value to 0 or to 1. Okay, so when it is a normal, no congestion, all these bits are set to 0. Okay, so here you want to inform to the backward direction, so you set this BECN bit to 0. If you want to inform to forward, in the forward direction, then you set this FECN bit to 0. Okay, and if you want to inform both, then both bit can be set. In both direction there is a congestion, then you can set this bit to 1, both, that there is direction congestion in both direction. Okay, this quality of service is, this is internet working issue, so that is provided, this quality of service is provided by this our transport layer TCP. So here first we should know what defines the quality for our flow of the data. First is the reliability. If your data is delivered without any loss, and if there is a minimum delay, there is a minimum jitter, and the maximum bandwidth utilization is there. So all these are the four characteristics of any data flow. Okay, so then there are different techniques which are used to improve this quality of service. One is scheduling, traffic shaping, resource reservation, and admission control. So scheduling is like when you know that first in first out, last in first out. This scheduling thing, I think you have studied in operating system also. You are aware of this scheduling policy. Like when there is a multiple processes for execution, so how that CPU time is allocated. So same way here, how those data which are coming in the queue, how these data is processed and forward on the network, on the way. Okay, so in the queue, the first in first out queue, so all the data which are received, they are stored in the queue, first in first out, and they are processed and transmitted, and if this queue is full, then you discard. Okay, if the queue is full, you cannot take any more data, you discard this. Then there can be a priority queue also. Sometimes we have to send important data, high priority data. So that time we can maintain two queues, high priority queue and low priority queue. So while sending the data, the sender will send the priority of that data, that it is important or not important. So accordingly, it is stored into this queues. And first high priority queue data is processed, and then low priority queue. And again, this switch will turn to queue when this high priority queue is empty, then it will turn to this lower priority queue. Again, if there is a data in higher priority queue, it will turn back and it will process that. Okay. So this classifier will decide whether your data is high priority or low priority queue. Then in this, what happens if every time it is processing high priority data only, then low priority data queues will be full, remaining data will be discarded, and there will be delay, then the timer will expire for the sender, then sender will retransmit the data. So again, that is going to increase the congestion and all those things. So what happens? There is weighted fair queue. Okay, so according to that, three queues are maintained and a different weightage is given. Okay, so if different weightage is given, suppose this is a high priority, this is a medium priority, this is a low priority, so three packets from the first queue will be processed, then two packets from this second queue will be processed, one packet from this packet queue, again three packet from this, two from this, one from this. So it means you are giving a fair chance to all queues depending on their priorities. Okay, so this is known as weighted fair queue. Okay, so according to the priority, a weightage is given, how many packets will be processed, and then this processing done, and then those packets are transmitted in the network. Then leaky bucket. Leaky bucket, and this this comes under traffic shaping. So we know that we cannot control the data generation rate of the sender. Okay, 12 MB, sometimes 2 MB, sometimes no data generations. Sometimes अगर suppose आपके घर में fresh water आ रहा है, बट वो वाटर जो है ऐसा फ्लो में नहीं आ रहा, रुक रुक के आ रहा है, एकदम से आएगा फिर रुकेगा, फिर एयर बबल्स आएंगे, फिर थोड़ा आएगा, फिर रुकेगा, फिर थोड़ा आएगा. अगर उसके हिसाब से हम काम करेंगे तो कंटिन्यूअसली वी कैन नॉट वर्क. सो व्हाट वी कैन डू, एक बकेट रख देते हैं उसके नीचे, ठीक है, तो उस बकेट में जिस रेट से भी आता है आने दो, बट बकेट में एक होल कर दिया हमने, उससे फ्लो जो है वो कॉन्स्टेंट रहेगा. जो बकेट में होल है उससे जो फ्लो आउट फ्लो हो रहा है वो कांस्टेंट रहेगा. ऊपर वाला फ्लो कभी सडनली जोर से पानी आ रहा है, बहुत प्रेशर से आ रहा है, कभी नहीं आ रहा है, कभी सिर्फ एयर आ रही है, डजंट मैटर, दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू अफेक्ट योर आउट फ्लो. सो दिस इज सिमिलर टू दिस लीकी बकेट. सो इफ वन सेंडर इज जनरेटिंग 12 Mbps फॉर 2 सेकंड्स, सो हियर इट हैज जनरेटेड 24 Mbps, देन इट इज नॉट जनरेटिंग एनी डेटा. देन इफ यू सेंड द डेटा एट द सेम रेट इन द नेटवर्क, तो अभी यहाँ पे भेजा तो तुम्हारा नेटवर्क में कंजेशन हुआ, यहाँ पे योर नेटवर्क इज एम्प्टी, यू आर नॉट यूटिलाइजिंग बैंडविड्थ, अगेन हियर 2 Mbps फॉर 3 सेकेंड्स. सो वॉट यू कैन डू, यू कैन स्टोर दैट डेटा इन टू अ बफर, एंड फ्रॉम दैट बफर यू ट्रांसमिट द डेटा एट द कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड. जितना डेटा आए, वट एवर स्पीड इट इज कमिंग, डजेंट मैटर, योर आउट फ्लो इज फिक्स रेट. ओके, सो दैट इज वी कॉल्ड एज अ लीकी बकेट. Okay, now that outflow, that is a fixed rate, it is not depending on the water which is coming from the tap or from the source which is generating the bursty data or no data at all. Okay, so this is how this is implemented, the data generated stored in a queue, and from the queue it is the packets are transmitted at a constant rate. Then basically it is shaping that bursty traffic into a fixed rate traffic, averaging out the data rate. Okay, so the packets will be dropped only if the bucket is full. Then token bucket. So token bucket is again traffic shaping policy, which is better version of leaky bucket. Okay, so in this, if some source machine or some sender is not transmitting any data for particular amount of time, so and next time when it won't, so it will get only that suppose there are four machines which are generating the traffic, okay, out of four only two machines are generating traffic, two are not generating any traffic, but it is a fair system. So when even those machines wants to transmit, they will get that average rate only. Suppose if they can generate 220 bytes per second or something like that, okay. But what about that when they were not transmitting? They should get credit for that. That time when they were not sending anything, they should get some credit for that. So next time when they have a data, they should get more chances to transmit their data. So that's why every time, every tick, a token is added. So per tick, per duration when that you can generate the data, a token is added. If you have data, the source has data, it will generate the data and add into the queue. If the machine is not having any data, it will earn that one token at a time. So those tokens are added. And according to the token, how many tokens you have, next time when it has some data to generate, it will get more chance to transmit its data. Okay, so that is token bucket. Okay, so this integrated service is, I don't know, this is in our syllabus or not, that I have to check. If it is in our syllabus, then only we'll discuss. Otherwise, we have so many other things to discuss. Okay. So is this clear? Quality of service and all those things are clear to you? Token bucket, leaky bucket. ये एग्जाम में दिस वाइवा पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ये अपना टीसीपी कंजेशन पॉलिसी, स्लो स्टार्ट, एक्सपोनेंशियल ग्रोथ एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स, एंड देन लीकी बकेट, ट्रैफिक शेपिंग, टोकन बकेट, ऑल दीज थिंग्स. ओके, एग्जाम में भी आता है एंड वाइवा में भी पूछा जाता है. इज दिस क्लियर टू एवरी वन, आई थिंक? ओके ओके. So we'll stop here today.